and welcome to this special episode. Today, we'll be talking about the Indian Super League as it has reached its halfway mark. It is no surprise that Mumbai City FC are at the top of the table with a 5-point gap over second-placed ATK Mohun Bagan. This year, we have seen few surprises, like Bengaluru FC sacking their coach after losing 3 straight games for the first time in the league. We have also witnessed the rise of Hyderabad and a rejuvenated Jamshedpur FC under coach Owen Coyle. Talking about a few teams in detail, let's begin with Mumbai City, who are at the top of the table. Mumbai City was failing a year back. However, with City Group coming in and former FC Goa coach Sergio Lobera taking over, it was no surprise that Mumbai City would be a force to reckon with. The Spaniards' philosophy has been the same: possession, passing, and the need to entertain, and it is exactly what they have been doing. Talking about 3-time champions ATK Mohun Bagan, they have been a compact team. They are also a well-drilled defensive unit. But when it comes to scoring, they only rely on their star forward Roy Krishna to provide them with the goals. ATK began the season with a great note, but they have hit a small snag on the way. They will be looking to redeem themselves and get back to winning ways when they play FC Goa on Saturday. The team which has surprised the fans this year is Hyderabad FC, as they have been playing some beautiful football. Hyderabad have made the 3rd most passes in the league as a team and have taken the 2nd most shots at goal among all the teams in the ISL. Goa's own Linston Culasso has made a sizable contribution towards the team. Another huge surprise we have seen this year is Bengaluru's collapse. Their last 4 games ended in losses to ATK Mohun Bagan, Jamshedpur FC, Mumbai City FC and SC East Bengal. The heart of Bengaluru's losses is the inability to score. With the defeats, manager Carl Squadrat, the Spaniard that took over from Albert Roca and led Bengaluru to the ISL title in 2018-19, mutually parted ways with the club. FC Bengaluru has currently appointed Naushad Musa as their interim coach. Let's talk about our very own FC Goa. They are currently on the 4th position of the table with 10 points behind league toppers Mumbai City. The Goas finished on top last season, but this year they have been struggling to get their desired results despite dominating most of the games. Ferrando's men have conceded the first goal in 8 out of their 10 matches. Lapses in concentration are not doing justice to their defense, which overall has performed decently. This year, the signing of Spaniard Igor Angulo has definitely filled the void which was created by ISL top scorer Ferran Corominas. Currently, Angulo has 9 goals out of 10 matches. As people have seen, FC Goa coach Juan Ferrando has been relying on young players like Saviour Gama and Princeton Ribello, as he wants to provide such players with more opportunities and help them grow. Talking about youngsters, we have one of them joining us today. To give a short introduction, I first saw him playing for FC Bardez in 2016. I personally went up to him and I told him that he would be great in life. Today, at the age of 23, he has taken the league by storm. He's a storehouse of energy, having the ability to run up and down the field at will and perform his duties. He's a regular starter now for the team. I would like to welcome FC Goa's left back, Saviour Gama, to the show. Saviour, welcome.
Hi.
Saviour, league ata halfway point paulo. FC Goa is in the 4th position. What is the atmosphere in the dressing room? Is the target still the same?
We all are very motivated. Me and the team is well focused and confident in going in the 2nd leg of the season. And we need to win many matches and be consistent in it. So that's the focus.
Saviour, yours are fans in an stadium. The players are secured in the secure bio bubble, away from family and friends. Do you feel that this has an impact on you and the team?
Yeah, of course it has. Like, we be in a same hotel and roam around us, same places in the hotel. So, of course, it's very kind of strange. Not a person who is used to be in the same place all the time. I like to roam and stuff. So, but the hotel has provided us with table tennis things and carom things and PlayStation and stuff. So it's very good to play and stuff when you're free.
Okay.
And the positive point is like we get to play football this season. So so happy about that.
Saviour, one thing I want to know, how has the team helped you all in the biosecure bubble?
The whole team and the staff is like a family now. We play together, eat together, do everything together. So, like all are my friends. So we talk and it has helped me from like being alone in the hotel all the time. And we got to know each other very well. That is even helping the team on the field.
Okay. But one thing I want to know is, yawar sa fans naan, tumka khyota na kahe dista, fans kahit naan yabadi stadium ante?
Without fans is very empty. The way they used to cheer and used to shout in the stadium.
Yes.
That's what we miss this year. Okay. But fans will always be in our hearts. And we go out there on the field, keeping them in our hearts and give it for them.
Saviour, you have played, you have started 9 out of 10 games as of now. How do you handle the pressure?
In the match day, I keep myself cool throughout the day.
Okay.
While doing the warm-up and stuff, I keep thinking about the football I'm going to play. And it helps me in the match.
Okay.
Gain confidence in the match.
Okay. You have started 9 games out of 10. How do you assess your season as of now?
I was waiting for this opportunity which FC Goa has given me. They trusted in me after the departure of Mandara Desai,
who
was the captain last year. So I need to fill in his boots. So it motivates me even more to give it all for the team.
Saviour, when it comes to you, what do you think you need to improve in your performance in the team to help the team?
I feel I need to improve in a lot of things.
Okay.
Defending wise, positioning wise, anyone attacking wise.
Okay.
And even though I improved, I need to be consistent in every game. That's what I aim for.
Okay. One thing the coach has always stressed on is foreign players need to be more like teachers to the Indian players and the youngsters and help them become better. Do they help the young lads? Which foreign player do you look up to the most?
Well, the foreigners in the team always guide us. When we do a mistake, they always tell us and help us be a better player. And I look up to all the foreigners in the team because they are very experienced and they know football better and they help us learn it even in a better way.
Any particular foreigner you look up to? You said all the foreigners, but any particular foreigner you look up to? Any favorite?
I look up to Ivan Gonzalez because he plays as a central defender who is very close. Because I'm a left back, and he tells me again and again to like what to do on the pitch.
Yeah,
and that helps me to gain confidence in myself and play.
Okay, let's talk a bit of personal life. What made you choose playing football, and when did you start playing football?
I started playing when I was in primary standard, maybe in second standard.
Okay.
So we used to have a PT period in which we used to play football with a cricket ball.
Okay.
So from then it started. And as year passed, I used to like play and play, and I fell in love with football.
Okay.
I used to play for my school teams a lot of times.
Okay.
So even in the higher secondary, I played. So it kept me going. Then I went on to play for clubs in the second division, third division, Goa League.
Could you name some of those clubs, please?
Murmugao United.
Yes.
Chikalem Youth Club. Then I entered into my professional career for FC Bardez.
Okay.
For Pro League.
I think you were under coach Armand Culasso and India's player Climax Lawrence, wasn't it, for FC Bardez?
Yes, yes. And they helped me a lot.
Okay.
Coach Armando liked me, liked my football. So I entered in my professional career for FC Bardez, who were in the Goa Pro League.
Yes.
Coach Armando was there.
Yeah.
Time. And Joki Castro was the one who took me there.
Okay. If you weren't a football player, what other profession would have you taken?
I never thought about anything else than football. When I finished my 12th, I had joined a hotel management course and they sent me for a 1 month training in a hotel. So first day of the training, they made me cut onions. And it was very disgusting. And
okay.
I did it. So from the next day, I left hotel management. So I would be unemployed without football.
So what, you're just 23 years old now. Have you thought about life after football maybe?
No, I didn't like think anything else rather than football yet. This is just the starting of my career. So I never thought about anything else rather than football.
Okay.
Yet.
Okay. Saviour, who is that one sports icon that has influenced you the most and how?
From when I was young, very young, I used to look at Leo Messi.
Okay.
Like he's a left-footed player and I used to watch his games and even now I watch. But since the ISL started, I looked at Mandar Rao Desai because he's an inspiration for me. I'm in touch with him and I take advices from him and he's my icon now.
Okay, Saviour, tell me one of the best moments and one of the worst moments in ISL you've gone through as of now, if you can recollect.
For me, the best moment was playing the ISL final against Bengaluru.
Okay.
And the moment was losing it.
Do you have any message for the supporters and the youngsters who look up to you?
Yeah, always dream big and keep chasing your dreams. Never give up. And if you work hard, then God will help you achieve your dreams.
Saviour, my last question to you. Any message for the fans?
Yeah, keep supporting us. You all will always be in our hearts as we play. Thank you very much for all your support. Forza Goa.
That was the ISL at halfway and our very own Saviour Gama. You all heard him speak and we will keep getting more players to y'all and some more analysis. Till then, keep watching Prudent.